Hey guys, and welcome to another Friday special maths tip, where again, we cover how to prevent careless mistakes in maths exams, part two. Be sure to check out part one from last week if you haven't. Sorry for not being in the video today. I know my sexy face makes these videos better, so I'll put a picture of me in the corner so it's as though I'm still here. All right, let's get started. Hope you guys like the new intro. Make sure to tell me below in the comments. When it comes to preventing careless mistakes, the number one strategy is to have a special strategy on how to complete maths exams. Before you walk into that exam, you know what your plan of attack for that exam will be. So in this video, I'll show you my plan of attack that helped me succeed in maths in high school and university. Is this the best plan? Well, once you've learned to execute it properly with lots of practice, then it is definitely one of the best. The first thing you need to know before starting the exam is what mark you want to get in that exam. If you're not aiming for 100%, then that means you don't need to complete every question. You have room to sacrifice marks in order to achieve your desired mark. Say you want 85%, then you only need to attempt 85 to 90% of the exam and get pretty much all those marks right and sacrifice the other 10 to 15% you can't do. People not aiming for 100% often waste so much time on lots of really hard questions they don't even need to answer in order to reach their desired mark. So with that in mind, let's go over the order and how to do the math exam. Let's start with reading time. In reading time, skim over multiple choice questions really quick and go over to short answers and ask yourself as you read each question, do I know how to do this straight away? Your answer should be yes or no. A maybe means no. You want to make mental notes of all the yes questions because once reading time is over, that's what you start with. Let's now consider the next problem you might encounter, and that's the questions. These are the ones you just stare at the page and have absolutely no idea how to do. Let's now summarize how to do the exam now once you can start. Firstly, skip multiple choice and go do every yes question first. Some multiple choice are worth a lot of marks and are a waste of time. So you want to leave those towards the end once you've gone through all the short answers. As say you have a minute left and you have a whole 15 marks of short answers to do versus 10 multiple choice. You can guess the multiple choice and get them right, but won't be able to do many of the short answers. When you go through and do all the yes questions, that means you probably won't be doing the paper in order, and that's fine. Just make sure to underline, not circle, the questions you're skipping for now, as you can come back to those later. Once you completed all the yes questions, go back and attempt every other short answer you skipped. If you come across an question where you're just staring at it for 30 seconds plus, or just really have no idea, circle it and move on. If you're not aiming for 100%, then this can be a sacrifice question. If you're sure you're going to sacrifice it, put a line through the whole question to indicate, nah, I ain't doing you. Next, go through and do multiple choice now that you have covered all short answers you can do. Now at this stage, you are not yet going to reattempt any of the circled questions you couldn't do. You're actually going to go back and recheck your answers to all short answers you've done. Now first off, any prove or show questions you were able to do, you won't have to recheck those as the answer is there. But when it comes to rechecking answers, you need to get scrap paper and redo the actual question without looking at the previous working. When you normally check over an answer, you don't always spot those careless errors. So make sure you're not contaminated by previous working, you redo it on scrap paper. You then compare if the answers are the same and you can move on to the next one. If the answers do not match, you will have to again redo it, but only after you rechecked all answers, unless you spot where you made a mistake. Now, by this stage, you should have checked all answers you've done are correct, meaning that you should have 100% for what you've attempted so far. Now, at this stage, you can reattempt the questions, but if you're getting nowhere, then check to see if you've attempted enough to get your desired mark and just sacrifice that question. Next, you can recheck multiple choice, followed by rechecking the questions you did in the previous step. Now, if you still have time left by here, then you should have your desired mark by now, meaning you can either do nothing and wait till the exam is over, or reattempt the questions you sacrificed, or again, re-recheck the other short answers. Now, this process may seem daunting and there's no way you'll have time to do all this. That's why it's important to practice this method at home numerous times first. Your first time doing this should not be in an exam. If we go back a few weeks ago, in my video on studying for maths exams, the last phase was doing past papers in exam mode. This is the time to adapt this strategy and make sure to practice it numerous times. Adapt this strategy as early as possible, from even year 8 or 9, definitely by year 10. That means once you get to year 12, you'll be an expert at doing maths exams. I hope you enjoyed this video and start practicing this strategy now. Make sure to give us a like, comment below what you thought. Also, make sure to subscribe and turn on those bell notifications to know when future awesome content is released. I will be uploading a new channel trailer soon to showcase the epic updates I'll be adding to this channel, so make sure to look out for that.